those players.
It's in your blood. Once you step there and you put on the uniform, you practice with those guys, go to war with those guys, it's going to be there forever.
I think we kind of pioneered it back in really 92. We had a real solid defense, and of course 93 we finished tops in the nation, and every year you just see those guys getting better and better and better, and it's like, you know, who's the greatest defense there? You know, you constantly get that argument amongst us.
I go play Miami, me and Terrell, we talk middle field, talk about Florida State. Play Tampa, Warwick Dunn, Derrick Brooks, talk about Florida State. Play Dallas, me and Dion, Florida State, wherever, doesn't matter. We have hundreds of players, and it's like big, and one guy started that. He demanded that. It's Coach Bowden. Whenever you see an alumni, ever, he's like your brother. You treat him with a lot of respect, and you love it.
With the 12th pick in the first round, Tampa Bay selects Warwick Dunn, running back, Florida State. With the fourth choice in the first round, the Baltimore Ravens select Peter Boulware, defensive end, Florida State. With the sixth pick in the first round, the Seattle Seahawks select Walter Jones, offensive tackle from Florida State. With the 14th pick in the first round, Cincinnati Bengals select Reynard Wilson, linebacker from Florida State.
Last year, there were more Florida State alumni playing in the National Football League than any other school in the country. 45 Seminoles were spread over the rosters of all but two of the teams in the NFL. The Seminole family in the NFL share a bond like no other. However, as notable as the Seminole program has been for advancing players to the NFL, the program has also earned a reputation as a place where players have chosen to return for their senior seasons. In 1988, Deion Sanders came back to school for his senior year as a walk-on after having played for the New York Yankees over the summer. He led the Tribe to a Sugar Bowl win over Auburn and won the Jim Thorpe Trophy. In 1991, fullback Edgar Bennett came back, graduated, and then went on to star for the Green Bay Packers, earning a Super Bowl ring. Derrick Brooks chose to earn his degree in 1994 and enhanced his draft status, becoming a first-round selection. Brooks just completed his third straight All-Pro season. Warwick Dunn said the millions could wait, and he earned his degree and a berth in a second national championship game before winning NFL Offensive Rookie of the Year honors in 1997. 3 years ago, Andre Wadsworth stayed in school and was the first defensive player taken in the 1998 NFL draft. Last year, Peter Warwick and Corey Simon stayed as Seminoles so they could help their team complete a perfect season, win a national championship, and get their degrees. And just 2 weeks ago, Chris Wehnke joined the elite group when he announced that the pull of the Seminole family was great enough to persuade him to delay his career in the NFL for one more year. The family bonds are strong. Being a Seminole is special.
For our fans, a Saturday to get to Tallahassee and to take part in it. No charge. We didn't want there to be a charge. We want fans to bring families. And then tonight, we culminate the day with our annual awards banquet. Mike Godfrey from ESPN is going to be our speaker. John Swofford will be here throughout the day with us, the Atlantic Coast Conference Commissioner. A chance for all Seminole fans to kind of just bask in the glory today.
Indeed it is, and it's been a great time ever since that Virginia Tech ball game, really leading into it. This exposure, we've mentioned it before, that Florida State got by playing in that national championship game, second one in a row, you really can't put a price tag on. Also got some really good news, maybe better news than the national championship almost, in that Chris Winkie made an announcement last week that he would decide to return for his senior season, setting just a tremendous trend in light of what's going on at some other universities in the country.
You know, Rob, we would be remiss if we didn't talk about the meaning of that. Chris Winkie comes back, Warrick Dunn comes back, Peter Warrick comes back, Andre Wadsworth elects to come back, and so on. We've had a number of players, and not all of them, some players have gone out because they felt that was best for them and for their particular family situation, etc. But to have the number of players we've had in a very high profile program make the decision to come back and pass on the money says a lot about what's happening within the football program at Florida State University. It sends a very positive message.
Really an unbelievable message, particularly when you look at Chris Winkie, and that I think he was getting probably 50-50 feedback that no one would have faulted him had he gone pro, and he decides to come back and be part of Florida State for another sequence. Now we got another new member of our staff. First of all, we'd be remiss if we didn't congratulate Chuck Amato, a longtime Florida State assistant head coach. He coached our defensive line, coached linebackers. He's gone on to his alma mater. He'll be a head coach in the ACC. We'll have this league taken over here pretty soon.
Well, it's interesting. We've got Tommy Bowden out, Clemson. Now Chuck goes to North Carolina State, and we're very, very happy for Chuck Amato. He did a terrific job here for our football program, always represented us very well. And it were those types of qualities is what attracted North Carolina State to Chuck. He's an NC State graduate, and he's very, very excited. He's very appreciative of his years here and has said that repeatedly in his transition. But we're excited for Chuck, and I hope he wins 10 games a year.
And we welcome aboard Joe Kines, who comes most immediately from the University of Georgia. Very familiar name throughout the South, one of the most respected assistant coaches in the country.
Has known Mickey Andrews for a long time. They've been both personal and professional colleagues throughout the years, and we're happy to have Joe Kines join us and bring the type of experience he brings in recruiting and coaching. He'll coach our linebackers.
We mentioned the ACC. Our teams are diving, some of them for the first time in ACC play, but the basketball teams have been there. Duke comes to Tallahassee on Monday night to play our women's team. Our men's team is on the road for a really tough stretch here.
We're in the middle.
Winner two. Get all the championship gear now. Your garnet and your gold when you surf on in to sunshinenetwork.com.
Pumping. Goes the side down the middle round. It's caught. 35-30 for the 20. 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Florida State. Pete Warrick. Here's the snap. Oh, it is blocked. It's blocked at the 5. Bounces back onto the field of play. Fielded by Cheney. Touchdown, Florida State.
The Noles rang in the new millennium, making headlines. Noles win another national title, and Bobby Bowden couldn't fit the Sears Trophy in his pocket, but he brought a second national title back to Florida State anyway. And today in Tallahassee, thousands of Seminole fans have turned out to honor their 99 wire-to-wire champions. It's the Dodge National Championship Celebration, Seminole style. The Sears Trophy, just one of the many trophies on hand today, as Florida State and their fans will salute the 1999 undefeated, undisputed Seminole football team, the national champions. Hello, everybody. I am Tom Block. So glad that you are here for this special day at Florida State, as we do pay tribute to the only team in the history of the Associated Press to go wire to wire, undisputed as the number one football team in the country. It is a gorgeous day in Tallahassee. Chilly this morning, but Seminole fans have certainly warmed up as they are here to honor their Seminoles. And coming up on this afternoon's program, we will hear from some of your Seminole heroes. We will, of course, hear from head coach Bobby Bowden, who will address the Seminole Nation as he put a big exclamation point on the end of his 24th season at FSU. We'll look back at the season highlights and also unveil the brand new championship banner, banner number two, here at Doak Campbell Stadium as FSU celebrates a second national title. Today's show is brought to you by Dodge. Do not follow, do not conform, be different. Welcome back to Tallahassee and Doak Campbell Stadium as we continue with our Dodge National Championship Celebration, Seminole style. It is a gorgeous day in our state's capital, and Seminole fans are out strong. And right now, let us go ahead and throw things up to the podium. Our master's ceremony today, the executive director of the Seminole Boosters, Charlie Barnes.
Are you ready to celebrate your national championship? Welcome to all Seminoles here in Doak Campbell Stadium. Welcome to everyone watching live on the Sunshine Network and listening on radio station WMLS. And welcome to all college football fans watching and listening around the world on the World Wide Web. The show will be repeated tonight on Sunshine at 10 p.m. All right, Seminoles, please help me welcome the distinguished guests on the platform today, some of our special guests in the press box. Starting here in the back row on the left side, the 1999 national chairman of the Seminole Boosters, Don Reinhardt. Next to him, we have Leon County Commissioner Jane Sauls. I am pleased to introduce the mayor of Tallahassee, FSU alum Scott Maddox. Joining us from the Sears Corporation, Mr. Bill Soroka. Now I would like you to welcome a great friend of Florida State and an FSU alumnus, the Speaker of the Florida House of Representatives, Mr. John Thrasher. And please give a great Seminole welcome to the Governor of the great state of Florida, Governor Jeb Bush. Governor Bush has signed a proclamation recognizing superior achievements of Coach Bowden and the 1999 Seminole football team. It's also my honor today to welcome Florida State University's President, Sandy Dallenberg. Next, our Director of Athletics, Mr. Dave Hart. And with us today to present the trophies is the Commissioner of the Atlantic Coast Conference, Mr. John Swafford. All right, well, I'm direct to direct your attention to the video board.
Dynasty. Only a handful of teams in the tradition-rich history of college football can lay claim to having a football dynasty. Most have long passed, except for one. The one belonging to Bobby Bowden's Florida State Seminoles. With a string of 13 consecutive 10-win seasons and top four finishes, the Seminoles have become the benchmark by which all others are measured. No other team can boast of the Seminoles' accomplishments during the 90s. Florida State has the highest winning percentage of any team of any decade and a record of 108-13-1. FSU has not lost at home in the friendly confines of Doak Campbell Stadium since 1991, a streak going back 46 games. The Seminoles are an amazing 8-2 in bowl games during the 90s, with their first national championship coming in 1993. So how does the 1999 team figure into this dynasty? This year's Seminole football team accomplished what no other Seminole team or college football team has ever done. Go wire to wire from preseason to finish as the number one team in the nation. This is the first undefeated team in Florida State football history. The senior class of 1999 was also the most successful in school history, boasting a remarkable 55-6 record. They are also the only group to win every home game, and they played in three national championships in the past four seasons. Simply amazing. When you talk about Florida State football, the name of Bobby Bowden is synonymous. In 1999, Bowden notched his 300th win in the first ever father-son game when his Seminoles beat Sun Tommy's Clemson Tigers. He is the second winningest active coach behind only Joe Paterno with 304 victories and is number five among all-time Division I-A coaches. He is number one in bowl winning percentage, boasting a record of 17-5-1. And his crowning glory came with the Seminoles' first ever undefeated season and second national championship in their 46-29 victory over the Virginia Tech Hokies in the 2000 Nokia Sugar Bowl. In 1999, Florida State won their eighth consecutive Atlantic Coast Conference championship, won the state championship by defeating Miami at home and the Florida Gators in Gainesville, and won their second national championship of the 90s with a 46-29 victory against the Virginia Tech Hokies, finishing with a record of 12 wins and no losses. Undefeated, undisputed, wire-to-wire number one, the 1999 national champions, the Florida State Seminoles.
And now, Seminoles, would you turn behind you and welcome our special guests on the platform outside the president's box. They include Commissioner of Education, Tom Gallagher. Senator and past president of the Jacksonville Seminole Boosters, Jim King. State Representative Al Lawson. State Representative Durrell Peden. State Representative Kelly Smith. State Representative Marjorie Turnbull. And Insurance Commissioner and State Treasurer, Bill Nelson. Florida State University has enjoyed unprecedented success, and our national championship in football will provide further exposure for academic achievements and advancements. We're so proud to represent this great university. Let's welcome our president, Sandy Dallenbert.
Sandy, thanks so much. It's incredible to think in the long history of college football, no other team has done what this team, the 1999 Seminoles, have done. To be number one at the beginning of the season and to end the season as national champion makes this university so very, very proud. Like the Seminoles, for which we take our name and our great traditions, this team is undefeated, unconquered, and very, very proud. We've learned to live in the swamp and prosper there, in fact. We've been able to survive hurricanes, and I'm very proud of what this team has done. They capped off this great season with a marvelous dinner of turkey gobbler in New Orleans, and I'm really so proud of what they've accomplished. They've helped to advance this university, and the whole university shares the pride of our athletic fans. Thanks so much, Shelley.
Thank you, President. Just as President Dallenbert has provided tremendous leadership to our entire campus, so has Dave Hart,
provided extraordinary leadership of our athletic program. We're striving in every area to be the absolutely best program in the country, and Dave Hart is making sure that we do it the right way. Ladies and gentlemen, our Director of Athletics, Dave Hart.
Thank you, Charlie. As has already been stated during the excellent video board presentation, all of you know and should know that the NCAA has formally declared Florida State University as a football dynasty. And in my mind, there's also no question that the Florida State Seminoles, with all due respect to Nebraska, the Florida State Seminoles are the team of the 90s, the team of the decade. And as Director of Athletics, as far as I'm concerned, you, the Seminole fans, are indeed the fans of the decade, and we appreciate what you mean to this program. I speak on behalf of everyone associated with a very proud tradition of excellence that's been established here under Coach Bobby Bowden and all the players who've come through this program. On behalf of all of those, I want to take this opportunity to salute you, the Seminole fans, for displaying your championship caliber throughout the way this program has grown and developed. Thank all of you.
Thank you, Mr. Hart. We have another special guest and alumnus of Florida State University with us today. He has risen to the position of Speaker of the Florida House of Representatives, and we are so pleased he could join his beloved Seminoles today. Please welcome the Speaker of the House, Mr. John Thrasher.
Thank you, Charlie. Coach Bowden and your great, great coaching staff and young men, and particularly you young men, remember this day. It is a very, very special day that the good Lord above has provided for us, and you'll remember it a long time. You know, politics and athletics have a little bit in common, Coach Bowden. Every now and then, you have some adversity that you have to overcome. And you young men know that. I know that you do. But when you overcome that adversity, the feeling of great success that you've overcome is just unparalleled. And you young men and this coaching staff overcame some adversity with dignity and with courage and with compassion. And I, for one, want to tell you thank you on behalf of all the people of the state of Florida. We're very proud of you, and we're very proud of Florida State University.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And now, one of the great young financial and civic leaders in our community, Don Reinhardt, led the Seminole Boosters to a record fundraising year, and he and his wife, Sarah, have made a personal contribution of $1 million to Seminole Athletics. Please welcome Don Reinhardt.
Thank you. I've been around Florida State University for most of all of my life, and this has been an absolute incredible opportunity for me to be a part of this perfect national championship year. But Seminole Boosters is not about me. It's not about Charlie Barnes. We have 17,000 plus individuals out there who give tirelessly of their money and their time every single day. And we're always asking them for more. They do that in hopes of having the opportunity to enjoy a dream such as a national championship. Gentlemen, let me thank you on behalf of the 17,000 plus Seminole Boosters around this world in allowing them the opportunity to not only accomplish your dream, but also accomplish their dream as well. Go Seminoles, and I'll see you in Miami.
When we return to Tallahassee, the Dodge National Championship celebration rolls on Seminole style.
Dodge Ram.
Perfect season of Bowden's career and marked the first time a team had ever maintained a number one ranking wire to wire. From preseason to the final poll, the Noles were number one. Congratulations to Florida State's players, coaches, and fans from Dodge, who remind you, do not follow, do not conform, be different.
90s and a university for the new millennium. I'm Burt Reynolds. In the past decade, my alma mater recruited its fifth Nobel laureate faculty member and more than 600 national merit scholars. We built one of America's most wired campuses and its newest national laboratory, climbing to a number three ranking in royalties from patents. You know, some people are wondering if they're ready for the new millennium. I wonder if it's ready for us.
Championship celebration Seminole style is brought to you by Dodge. Do not follow, do not conform, be different. The celebration rolls on, and let's head back up to the podium.
I just want to thank you and the 1999 Florida State Seminoles for all you have done for our community. You certainly have given us a lot to boast about by bringing this beautiful crystal football back to FSU. And on behalf of the board, I present you with this resolution and congratulations from Lee County. Thank you.
All right, you remember, here we go. Now I want to direct your attention to the war board for some of FSU's most memorable plays. Are you ready?
Great game.
State.
A great season.
We've
got one more to go.
All right.
And the best part is it's going to be in New Orleans.
Showtime, baby. That's what it is.
Running back. Here's a handoff in the backfield. Loose football. Diving for it. Seminoles may have come up with it.
Yes.
I think we did.
Yes.
Big play. Florida State defense. 36 Winky. Pump fake. Throws the side down the middle route. It's caught. 35 30. For the 20. 15. 10. 5. Touchdown. Florida State. Pete Clark. No, it is blocked. It's blocked at the 5. Bounces back onto the field of play. Fielded by Cheney. Touchdown Florida State.
Well, you know, I'm glad I'm not the coach. They brought the house. They blocked it. Touchdown.
Here's the snap. Wink. Crossing back. Caught Dugans. 50, 40, 35, 30, 25, 10, 5. Touchdown. FSU. Take a one bounce. Warwick's going to field it at the 40. To the 30, 45, to the 50. 40-yard line. 30-yard line. 25, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown. Florida State. Peter Warwick. He should drop him when he throws toward. Fake by Vic, tries to break the chain, running to his left. Will be hit for drive. Oh, the football! Yeah! Football. Yeah! Knowles think they got it. I think we do, too. 43 of the Hokies dropping Winky, looking Winky. Wants to throw the knockout punch to Warwick. Warwick open! Cannot make the catch. Flags thrown to the wall.
Touchdown! He gets a touchdown. He did catch it. Touchdown, Florida State. Oh, Peter Warwick, how'd you do that?
Shotgun dropping. He's going to be clobbered at the 12-yard line. Florida State is the national champions of college football.
With the nation's most prestigious academic and athletic conference, the Atlantic Coast Conference. Here today to present several trophies is the commissioner of the Atlantic Coast Conference, Mr. John Swofford.
Charlie, thank you very much. Let me first say to all of you, the players whose blood, sweat, and tears have made this all possible, the coaches, Coach Bowden and his staff, President Sandy Dallenberg, Athletic Director Dave Hart, you, the Seminole fans, the Atlantic Coast Conference is very, very proud of you, very, very appreciative of what you've accomplished and what you mean to the entire league. It's a privilege and an honor for me to be here with you today and have the opportunity to present again four trophies to Florida State University. And the first one that I present is one that I guess is closest to my heart and one that you're getting very, very used to. And this one will certainly not be lonely in your trophy case because it is the eighth in a row, the Atlantic Coast Conference Championship. The ACC championship and that great win in Gainesville propelled you into the BCS and the national championship game. And the next trophy to be presented as champions of that game against Virginia Tech in New Orleans, the Sugar Bowl trophy, Sugar Bowl championship. And next, something that I don't think has ever been done before, going wire to wire, ranked number one in the country from the beginning of the prior to the season to the end of the season, the Associated Press National Championship Trophy. And the last trophy, and the one that I know you're most proud of here today, and I'm glad to see that the top of it, the crystal part, is here because I saw Coach Bowden try to put it in his pocket and leave with it in New Orleans. Fortunately, his pocket wasn't quite big enough. But before we formally present that trophy again, let me bring up Mr. Bill Soroka from Sears and President Dallenberg. Along with this trophy goes a $20,000 check to Florida State University for the General Scholarship Fund from Sears. And again, as I present the Sears National Championship trophy, and it is a beautiful Waterford crystal from Ireland, let me again thank Florida State and all of you who have meant so much to this national championship and made it happen. Let me express to you the ACC's appreciation for what you mean to us and what you've accomplished. Ladies and gentlemen, the Sears National Championship Trophy.
When we return to Tallahassee and Doak Campbell Stadium, we'll hear from Corey Simon and Chris Winkie. That's when the Dodge National Championship Celebration Seminole style continues after this. Do not follow, do not conform, be different. While we were away, the war chant echoed through Doak Campbell Stadium here in Tallahassee, Florida. And right now the celebration continues as we head back up to the podium to hear from some Seminole stars.
Okay, here we go. Our Seminole defense crushed and overwhelmed opponents this year. Let's watch now as the Seminole defense shuts them down. Players in Florida State history. Corey Simon makes us all proud. Here he is, senior nose guard, consensus All-American, and team captain, Corey Simon.
Fans we have out there. So you know what I'm talking about.
Finally, the national championship has come back to Tallahassee!
Just to thank you guys for coming out, for making this a memorable moment for myself as well as my teammates. All year we've had to fight and we've had to struggle through adversity, and every step of the way you've been there for us, and we just want to thank you for that. I know my teammates are going to miss me. grilling them in those meetings when I stand up and I give them that long speech. But I'm going to let you guys know that I'm going to miss the fans as well as my teammates. And next year, I hope to come back for this same day to celebrate a 2000 national championship. And last of all, I want to thank the coaching staff and Coach Bowden. And I want to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And I want to thank you. Go Seminoles!
Thank you, Captain Corey Simon. Now, we'll get a chance to relive some of the highlights that the offense put together during this wire-to-wire title run. Of the offense today is the unquestioned leader of this group. He has won 20 straight games and led the Seminole to our first undefeated season. Now he wants to come back and do it all over again next year. Welcome quarterback Chris Wakey.
I'm getting too old for this. Just to reiterate some of the things Corey said, obviously this just isn't us that won the national championship. It starts with the coaching staff, the administration, the boosters, the cheerleaders, and you, the fans, because without you, we wouldn't have won it. We faced some adversity on offense. You come out preseason number one, and no one really knows this, but we're missing five guys from our starting lineup going into the season through injury or something else, and yet we found a way. And I think that was our motto all year. We did face some adversity, like Corey said, but we found a way to win, and that was the bottom line. And I think this day is a very special day. It's personally special for me because I didn't know if I'd ever play again after my injury. But to be a part of this team is very special. Just to go back just for a couple seconds and think about what this team has accomplished. No team ever in the history of the Associated Press has ever gone preseason number one and finished number one. That's an unbelievable feat and a tribute to these players and coaches. We had to deal with Coach Bowden trying to get his 300 victory against his son, and we had to go down to the swamp and drain that thing, but that sure was fun. And then we had to wait 46 days to go try to win a national championship, and if anyone knows anything about this team, and we've been known to talk a little bit, and we've got a few guys that like to talk, but no one's ever talked like that team from Virginia Tech. But I guess we found out talking doesn't win a national championship, getting it done on the field. I think my time is up, but again, I want to say thank you to the fans. When we run out here out of the tunnel on Saturday afternoons, when this place is packed, there's nothing better. You get chills running through your bones. Maybe you guys don't realize that, but without you guys, it's not as fun on Saturdays. And in closing, I just got one question. Who's Corey Moore?
Return to Tallahassee. The Dodge National Championship Celebration Seminole style rolls on, and we'll hear from head coach Bobby Bowden. keeping the Seminole spirit alive and well at Doak Campbell Stadium as the Dodge National Championship Celebration Seminole style rolls on. Back up to the podium now, and the executive director of the Seminole Boosters, Charlie Barnes.
Coach Bowden's speech to the players in the locker room at the Sugar Bowl.
As long as we're together, nobody can whip us. So we're all together.
This is exactly what you want. This is what you work for. This is what we want, man. You know, a shot at the national championship. Everybody in the country is going to see you play. You know, boy, it's exactly what you want. Now, don't use that against yourself and make yourself tight. Don't get all tight. Everybody's watching. I might make a mistake. Don't worry about mistakes. You prepared yourself good. So just go out and play the best you can play and try to have a good time. Main thing is just hit. Play physical. Just play hard, you know? That's all you're going to do. 60-minute game. And the last thing I got, great players make great plays.
For Coach Bowden's empty picture frame.
Florida State is the national champions of college football. Perhaps Chris Fowler said it best on ESPN when he said to Coach Bowden, Coach, all you did this year was celebrate your 50th wedding anniversary, play your son in the first ever father-son matchup, take home an eighth consecutive ACC title, and win your second national championship. All we can say to Coach Bowden is thank you for being a Seminole. Ladies and gentlemen, Coach Bobby Bowden.
You did a great job at the Sugar Bowl. Get this one like that. Okay, good. Out of all those things that he mentioned there, that 50 years was tough, I'm gonna tell you. Well, I want to talk about the football team. I have limited time, and I want to spend as much as I can on the football team. This team here set the standard. We've always been trying to set the standard. We've had quite a few 11-1 football teams. People continually ask, well, who's the best? Who's the best you've ever had, you know? And it would take a 12-0 team to do that. So this team has set the standard. As we mentioned a while ago, the first team to go undefeated from wire to wire. We didn't mention these guys never lost in Tallahassee, Florida. They never lost in Tallahassee, Florida. I've been waiting quite a while for one of our teams to be the best, to be the winningest team of the last 4 years or 5 years while they were here. This team became the winningest group of these seniors for the past 4 or 5 years of any team we've had. And it looks like there's a race between Nebraska and Florida State for the team of the decade, and surely we're going to have to win that doggone thing. I think that last game might have clinched it. Now, listen, every football team has to establish an identity. Every team has to establish an identity. You know, you can identify with our 87 team, our 88, 89, 90 is up through now. This team had a personality too, and I want to try to describe it to you. I thought in the Louisiana Tech game, the first game of the year, the first half showed you the personality of this football team because they played that way all year. Florida State scored first, 7-0. Then in the second quarter, surprisingly, Louisiana Tech scores and you have a 7-7 ball game. Then they get the ball again and drive down to our 4-yard line. Louisiana Tech's fixing to go ahead. If we stop them, they're gonna kick a field goal, you know, but they fumble. Our team created a fumble and our team turns around and goes 90-something yards for a touchdown, you know, and take a 14-7 lead. Now, that wasn't the greatest moment this year, you know, but it gave you an idea of what kind of team this team was. I think of the Miami ball game. They score, we'd come right back and score. They'd score, we came right back and score. We answer them every time. Then the second half, they couldn't answer. You know, we got a couple and they didn't. The Clemson ball game, same way, down 14-3. Come back the second half, defense shuts them down, offense puts up there what they have to win, and another, their personality shows. And then the Virginia ball game, down 10-7, you know. And as soon as Virginia scored, we came right back, went 90. Came right back, went 90, and matched it up. You know, then they scored a field goal. Then we scored the rest of the points that day. Again, coming from behind. And then in the Florida ball game. Yeah. Don't give me none of that Florida who. I said Florida. When we went behind Florida in the third quarter, our team comes right back and scores and scores and scores, you know. So their personality began to show. Some people think it's a weakness to be behind. Folks, it's not a weakness to be behind. You know, not if you can come back and win it. It's one of the greatest teaching experiences you'll learn in life is to be behind and then come back to win. And until that happens to you, you don't know what kind of team you got. That's why I felt real good going against Virginia Tech. They had only been behind one ball game. We'd been behind about four different games. And every time, the team came back and won. That was their personality. The other thing is this, let me say this, I've only got about a minute. You talk about a team. This year, when our defense faltered, which wasn't very often, but the Miami game would be a pretty good example of defense faltering. But that day, our offense just picked it up. Our kicking game picked it up. And then the games where our offense faltered, such as Clemson, our defense just held us in there and created an opportunity to win. And our kicking game. So I'll wrap up. They're cutting me all short. I'll finish this tonight. Y'all come to the banquet. I will finish this tonight. But this was a team, and that's why we won. And I'm proud of these young men. To represent the best football team we've ever had at Florida State University. And the coaching staff, what a great job they've done. Thank you very much.
When we come back to Doak Campbell Stadium, we'll unveil the brand new national championship banner. That's when we continue right after this.
Excuse me, we need wings.
Champions. Congratulations from Sunshine Network on your perfect season and number one ranking.
Dodge National Championship Celebration Seminole Style is brought to you by Dodge. Do not follow, do not conform, be different. Once again, at the podium, Charlie Barnes.
Okay, Seminoles.
Now for the unveiling of the national championship banner. I'll direct your attention once again to the video board, actually just under the war board, where Doak Campbell Stadium will get a new, well-deserved, and hard-earned addition.
In just a moment as we continue with the Dodge National Championship Celebration here on Sunshine Network.
Dodge salutes Bobby Bowden and his national championship Florida State Seminoles on their exciting Sugar Bowl victory. The win in New Orleans capped off the first perfect season of Bowden's career and marked the first time a team had ever maintained a number one ranking wire to wire. From preseason to the final poll, the Noles were number one. Congratulations to Florida State's players, coaches, and fans from Dodge, who remind you, do not follow, do not conform, be different.
Those who ponder the natural order of things might be surprised that
up next, Sugary Sweet, a Seminole celebration. A special post-game look at Florida State's big win in the Sugar Bowl over Virginia Tech, complete with comments from players and from Bobby Bowden as well. Florida State, undisputed, undefeated national champs. So long from Tallahassee.
Way to go, Noles. Another national championship. Now celebrate the victory at sunshinenetwork.com. Join the team, show your pride, and be a winner too. Get all the championship gear now. Your garnet and your gold when you surf on in to sunshinenetwork.com.
Home of the Seminoles. Sunshine Network. First in Florida sports.
Now, here it is, what, 7 years later? Oh, he's never won two. Oh, he's never won two. He's always here. It's a shame a guy that old ain't ever won two. You know, really, that's what I'll catch if we lose. Poor thing, he ain't gonna ever win one, you know? How much longer will he live? And all that stuff. So I need to win it bad. I need to win it bad.
Wakey pumping, goes the sun down the middle route. It's caught 35, 30 for the 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Florida State, Pete Warren. Here's the snap. Oh, it is blocked. It's blocked at the 5. Bounces back onto the field of play. Fielded by Cheney. Touchdown, Florida State.
From the Superdome in New Orleans, for Florida State has won its second national championship in the history of Garnet and Gold football, along with Keith Jones, Paul Kennedy, and you might say FSU got a kick out of coming to the Big Easy.
They really did, Paul. They scored two touchdowns defensively, one off of a Peter Warrick punt return, a second off a Tommy Polly block punt, and then they shove it in the second, third, fourth gear in the third and fourth quarter offensively.
Yeah, quite a kick into high gear in the fourth quarter when Virginia Tech went in front.
Tech goes up by one. Florida State takes the ball on the 15-yard line, drives 85 yards, and then it's the Peter Warrick show, wrested away.
Let's go join what is a sugary sweet Seminole celebration as they celebrate a national crown. As Dodge presents Sugary Sweet, a Seminole celebration, brought to you in part by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Florida, who asks, what if you didn't have to worry about health care? By ACCtoday.com. Follow the Seminoles on the internet at ACCtoday.com. And by Checkers. Fresh, because we just made it.
Dodge Caravan is available with a value package that includes air, 7-passenger seating, and convenient storage areas at a very affordable price. This package has helped sell one caravan after another, after another. Now Caravan is the world's best-selling minivan. Special value, best-selling. Get the picture? Get 0.9 financing for 60 months or $1,500 cash allowance on Dodge Caravan.
Excuse me, we need wings, lots of wings.
How many?
Well, it's a Super Bowl party. How many do you think?
Eating was believing. As Dodge presents Sugary Sweet, a Seminole celebration. From Florida State's Director of Athletics, Dave Hart, throughout the Seminole Nation, unbridled joy as the Seminoles' emotions overflowed, college football's newly crowned king. Travis, you said you would feel faster on a carpet. Did you indoors tonight?
I mean, we just did what we had to do. I mean, we took advantage of what they gave us, and that's what it came down to. We just played as a better team today.
In the third quarter, they got a tremendous amount of momentum. It got tough on your offense.
Yeah, we knew we had to respond, and we came up big. I mean, we jumped out on them early, but we knew they would never quit. Watch them on film. I mean, they're definitely a team that played four quarters, so we knew we had to get some more points up.
What happened at the outset of the fourth when you raised the bar? You were trailing, facing third down. Here we go.
We just knew we had to make a play. I mean, this is something you work on all season, and it came down to it, so we just had to come up big.
For the Seminole assistant coach, with the longest tenure, his silver anniversary season produced the gold ring.
I'm with Jim Gladden now. Coach, it's been a difficult year for you. You spent some of it in the hospital. Does this make up for a little bit of pain and suffering?
Well, it sure does, Keith. It's a long time coming. We've struggled with this game, you know, three different times that we've come up empty-handed. And this is big for our team, it's big for the program, and it's big for me because I miss, you know, some time with that hip.
Most wins in the 90s. This one's officially in 2000, but it's quite a way to cap off a decade.
It is a great way to cap off a decade and start the new millennium as the national champions in that. You know, they've got to say that we're the dominant program of the 90s.
The up-and-coming program of the 90s, Tech knifed at times through the Knoll D until it hit steel, a trait instilled by coordinator Mickey Andrews.
Mickey Andrews, your emotions, your thoughts.
Ugliest pretty win that I've ever been around. Gave up a lot of plays. We had trouble trying to tackle a quarterback. He's unbelievable. But we came up with enough big plays in the kicking game. We got field position for the offense a couple times. Ended up with enough points to win. It was a great team effort.
One of the graphics that was shown during the game is that Tech has blocked 63 kicks in the 90s, Florida State at 28, but you get one for a touchdown tonight.
Well, that was big, and then the punt return too, you know, Pete had. But we slipped a little bit in our kickoff coverage a time or two and our punt coverage, but that was a great win for our kids.
When you look back on it, is this as satisfying as 93?
It's better because it's now.
The ultimate team game produced innumerable Seminole heroes, including punt returning Braveheart, Reggie Durden.
Reggie?
Yeah.
Scoreboard says 46-29. What's it feel like?
It feels great. It feels great. A perfect season. We couldn't did it no better. 12-0. Coach Baum got his 300 win. He beat his son. 12-0. It couldn't be better. National champs.
Have you faced anybody as quick as Michael Vick?
Michael Vick, I'm there. Y'all better watch out for that guy. Michael Vick, that's the next Charlie Heisman. That's the next Heisman Trophy winner. I mean, Michael Vick is great. What can I say? Y'all seen him on film today. I mean, at the game today. He's just great.
When you came into the ball game, did Coach Andrews say we were going to press, or we're going to lay back, or we're going to mix it up?
I mean, we came in at the beginning, we were saying we was going to press, and we did. We came out and pressed, but then after the long bomb on us, we just decided, hey, look here, let's get off a little bit. We don't need to press all the time. Let's just get off a little bit. We made that adjustment, and look at it now.
You've got some seniors on the defensive side of the ball that really came through all year long.
Yeah, I mean, that's been going on the whole year. Corey Simon, Jerry Johnson, all of them. Them boys, they've been here 5 years, so they know what. They know what it's all about Florida State football. And plus, we had the vets come back, and they was talking to us on the sideline, too. So we kept our head in the game, and when we went down, we didn't panic. I mean, we've been down before. We just came out, played together as a team, and won the thing.
What's it mean when some of these guys that are playing on Sunday come back and watch you guys play on a Tuesday night?
It means a lot. I mean, I'm glad they did come back because they come to us and talk to us and tell us what to watch for. I mean, the coaches just wouldn't say to us or nothing, and they'll come to us and tell us what we need to watch out for and what we need to do. And we did that, so we improved on that.
Reggie, go celebrate.
Okay, baby.
Congratulations.
Thank y'all. Hey, I'd just like to shout out to everybody in Tallahassee in today's time. It's going down in New Orleans, baby. We doing it.
To the victor of the 66th Sugar Bowl, a new trophy for the King of the Road.
Saturday, January 22nd, watch 60 NFL players tackle the Greens at the Campbell's NFL Players Super Shootout. Get inside the huddle for a brutal game of monster golf. The leaderboard is a who's who of the gridiron.
Bring the big fella in tight, he can show you the catch.
Witness the best and the worst golf you've ever seen. Be on the sidelines at Innisbrook at 8 a.m. for an all-pro lineup of attractions. Bring the family. Autographs are free. $2 off with a published cash register receipt.
You drive for show, you punt for the dope.
Checkers.
Way to go, Knowles. Another national championship. Now celebrate the victory at sunshinenetwork.com. Join the team, show your pride, and be a winner too. Get all the championship gear now. Your garnet and your gold when you surf on in to sunshinenetwork.com.
Tribe is conjuring up a hex to deter the Blue Devils from dominating the ACC. Duke at Florida State, Monday at 7:30.
Need money? Then watch this.
So what bothers you most about network marketing companies?
Overpriced products.
My brother-in-law.
Getting invited to meetings. They won't tell you what it's all about. It's
like, or the long-lost friends you haven't seen in 10 years. Have I got a deal for you, old buddy, old pal?
Hey, one of these days, I'm going to make a bumper sticker that says, I'd rather be your friend than in your downline.
So you don't like network marketing?
Actually, networking is probably the oldest, most...
Traditional
way of marketing a product.
And potentially the most profitable.
Exactly. You know, I just don't like the way most companies do it.
So what I'm hearing is it's not the principle.
No. All business is network.
Doctors, lawyers.
Right. Networking, if it's done right, it should be a business, not a game.
Hey, I just want to make a lot of money.
I can handle that.
Please, do yourself a favor and your family. Go to the phone and make the call now.
And chances are, you're already doing the hard work. You're just not getting paid for it. Please, go to your phone, pick it up, and make the call now, and make a vote for you.
For 24-hour ordering.
Home of the Seminoles, Sunshine Network, first in Florida sports.
Dodge presents Sugary Sweet, a Seminole celebration of Florida State's first perfect season and at times perfect play. From Florida State's offense, its defense, and the kicking game too, Hunter Keith Cottrell's superb second quarter effort spun like Dixieland jazz, so close the Tex goal line.
Keith Cottrell, early on, the offense dominated on Virginia Tech's side of the ball, but your offense came back alive in the second half.
Hey, whoever scores the most points wins. It doesn't matter how much time of possession you have. It's the amount of points on the scoreboard at the end of the ball game, and we're number one.
Absolutely. You kicked in the second quarter. One went dead on the one-yard line. One went barely into the end zone. Had you worked on it all time during time?
We'd worked on it the whole time, trying to get them to have to go 90 yards. You saw what Michael Vick can do. Make him go farther. That's all we're thinking.
Best feeling in the world.
It hadn't hit me yet, but holy cow. We're number one.
Thank you, Keith.
Like Keith corralled KJ, State's defense at times collared Michael Vick. But Bronny senior tackle Jerry Johnson knew it wasn't going to be easy to earn that championship ring.
Jerry Johnson, first half, Michael Vick up and down the field. Second half adjustments, you shut him down. Great, great victory.
Yeah, I started to get a little nervous in the third quarter when they had us 29-28. I was like, oh my gosh, not again this year. But our offense really pulled together. It just did it for us today. Our defense had to pull together that third quarter and not point fingers at each other, in which we did, and we came out with a victory this year.
You faced the number two Heisman in Hamilton, the number three Heisman in Vick. What are your emotions and thoughts about Michael Vick?
I think he's one of the best out there. I feel sorry for the teams that he got to face the next couple years around here, because he sure is going to get him fits.
You're a senior. Your last time, your thoughts?
I went out with a bang. After 5 years, I finally got me one. It feels great.
5 years for Jerry Johnson, and six seasons past another cast, earning the Seminoles' very first crown. Well, the alumni hit the field just like the Noles. Peter, you come back and you have to be proud of your alma mater.
I'm very proud. I mean, they worked hard. This first year, they've gone wire to wire, you know, and something I never could do. So, I mean, I'm out here supporting them and feel like I'm part of the team.
What about some of the assignments they had defensively tonight? Number seven in white, really elusive guy.
Oh, yeah. I mean, he's a tough guy. You know, he's a tough quarterback, and he's going to be good in the future. You know, and VTech played a great game, but, you know, Florida State just came out and gave it all they had, and they came out on top. You know, I'm proud of them.
They were punishing. They seemed to wear him down toward the end. Very physical, and it began to show in the fourth quarter.
Right, and that's really how you can stop a guy like that. I mean, it's kind of hard to stop a guy from making plays like that, but if you keep punishing and keep hitting him like that, it slows him down, and he keeps looking for it. So, I mean, that's the way they slowed him down, and he did a good job doing it.
Remarkable what you were able to, foundation you were able to lay, most wins in the decade of the 90s, FSU.
Yeah, I mean, that's something that I'm proud of. Anywhere I go up to Baltimore, anywhere across the country, everybody knows about Florida State, and I'm proud to be a Seminole.
Offensive coordinator Mark Richt rocked Tech on its heels with unpredictable play calling, like this flea flicker producing a 33-yard connection with Peter Warwick. A slice of a 329-yard, four-touchdown aerial assault.
Offensive coordinator Mark Richt, defense got you 14 in the first half, but you turned the juices on in the second half.
We did, but first of all, I got to say this. The glory and the honor of this game goes to Jesus Christ, my Savior. And other than that, we got a bunch of guys that won't quit. For some reason, our backs got to be to the wall before we decide to play our rear ends off. And as soon as we went behind, they just clicked into gear again and did what they had to win. But great defense by Tech. And we left our defense out there way too long. And I'm just thankful that we won the game.
When you look at the receiver core with Warwick and Ronnie Dugans and Jermaine Stringer, you got three guys that really came through for you this year on the senior leadership side.
All the way. All of our seniors did a great job. Whitaker and Eric Thomas and anybody I forgot. You know, all the seniors did a heck of a job for us. And, of course, Winky's leadership and stability was the difference in our season, I think.
Did you think you had to change some things, and did you change some things early on when the offense just wasn't clicking there in the first quarter?
Well, the only thing we changed was second half. We put Pete in a different position in our four wide set to keep him from doubling. I think they had a good plan for where he was sitting. And when we moved him a little bit, it freed up a little more space. But other than that, some situations came up, like the touchdown to Ron Dugans. There was a play that we thought would be there. They happened to be in the right coverage. And we got the matchup we wanted, and it worked just beautifully. But just really, it's more about guts. It's about not turning the football over, guys wrapping up the ball, and just fighting their hearts out. And that's what happened. That's why we won.
Two national championships in the 90s, most wins in the 90s, an offense that is beyond question coming to form under the Mark Richt system. We wish you the best of luck and congratulations.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you, Keith.
The biggest foot New Orleans has ever seen didn't belong to John Lafitte, but to a Pole who produced, and Sebastian Janikowski. Sebastian, how is this? What a way to finish this year for you.
It couldn't be better. You know, from high school, my senior year, where I played football, I didn't know I was going to end up in a national championship game.
I thought we were going to get a chance to see a 68-yard field goal there in the first half. I did the math. They elected to punt. Keith Cottrell pinned them down low. Did you have some of those thoughts that maybe you were going to get?
I got thoughts that I was going to get a long one, but oh well. You know, coaches make their decision. As long as we win the game, I really don't care.
The man who was in the news the most this week is Sebastian Janikowski. How do you look back on it now?
I'm looking the same way I looked before. You know, everybody made a mistake on the personal life, but always you learn from it. So I'm just happy being with the national champion.
Is this, in your estimation, as you leave the field tonight, your final game in garnet and gold?
Definitely it's going to be final game, and probably where I go in the locker room, I'm going to cry.
Tears of joy and a lot of cheering. The inside story just ahead.
How long does it take to turn Dodge Durango from the sport utility with the most passenger room in its class into the one with the most cargo room? Not long enough. Dodge Durango, different.
It's impossible to think about additives and preservatives in a place like this. Gold Kissed Farms chicken tastes fresh from the farm, because it is. While our owners aren't into flashy limos and vanity plates, they do enjoy having their name on the door. Farmer-owned Gold Kissed Farms chicken tastes fresh from the farm, because it is.
The Sprint Yellow Pages has pretty much everything you need to know.
Presenting State University's valedictorian.
The Central Florida Sprint Yellow Pages, the best read Yellow Pages.
Tonight on Action News, a huge night in the world of sport.
But that's much later in the show. First up, cloning a woolly mammoth.
Tired of waiting for the sports? Four nights a week for an entire hour each night, there's a place to satisfy your sports appetite. Up-to-the-minute sports desk news, editorial and predictions from Florida's top sports writers, live interactive fan polls, and love them or hate them.
Perfect game, I'm retired
on any given day.
How to run offense.
For the teams that want
to. Sunshine Network Live, Florida Sports Now.
Welcome back to Dodge presentation of Sugary Sweet, a Seminole celebration. And you're on the inside.
Coach, how you feel, Coach? Tell me now, with a man to tell.
I feel wonderful.
Yeah?
I want to say a special prayer for you. What a night it was.
Check,
that'd be great.
So
everybody gets in here.
Hey, thank God. We're going to the White House, baby. We're going to chill with Bill. We're going to the White House, baby. All right, baby. We're going to get us another one.
You're the best, man.
That's okay.
You're the best.
Yeah. Good luck, buddy.
Mike, can this season get any better for these guys?
Yeah.
Tonight it did. Congratulations on a great championship. I can't tell you how proud we are that you all won the Nokia Sugar Bowl Championship, which this year is the national championship, Coach Bowden.
Thank you very much.
Come back and do it again soon.
National champion! Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Chuck, hold it. Chuck, guys. Hey, guys.
Here you
go. Here's that for Coach Bowden's empty picture frame.
Yeah.
It's okay with y'all. Is this okay? Hello? Yeah. How come you're not working tonight? Huh? Hey, buddy, you really got your work cut out for you there, and we'll sure be pulling for you in that here.
Hey, guys, knock it out!
Well, you know, they really did. When we got behind, you really find out what you're made out of, and our kids came back, and we're right proud of it. I really appreciate your call. Well, thank you. Yeah. Well, that's good. I didn't know if you heard that mind, but I appreciate that because, you know, somebody's got to take care of these darn kids, don't they? Yeah, well, listen, I appreciate it. I know it. Yeah, and nobody's going to face it like you do. And, of course, coaches and all the politicians face the same thing. But I sure appreciate your support. I'm so glad. We're thrilled that you were able to see it. I really, really feel good about that. And I sure appreciate your kind words. Hey, all I can say is go Hogs. Go Hogs, huh? Now, didn't they though? I know you're proud of them, and I am too. You take care of yourself. See you, buddy.
Bye. Hey, y'all. Even America's chief executive appreciated Florida State's second half surge. A wave of character with men like Jeff Chaney changing the game's final outcome.
With Jeff Chaney, Jeff, you get in there and get some playing time, big playing time in the second half, and you made some big things happen.
Well, I mean, at any given time, any player can get that number called, and mine just got called. So, I mean, I just had to come in and step it up, play like a first teamer.
Tarlis Thomas was over there just a minute ago, and he was doing his Lee Corso impersonation of Jeff Chaney. Let's hear it. Can you do yours?
Hey, I can't do it, man. I ain't no good at that. I mean, I just come out and try to give my all on every play, and I mean, God just blessed me with a talent to be in the situation that I was in.
Now, Coach Billy Sexton does rotate you and Travis Miner, so you know you're going to get some playing time coming into every ball game. Do you prepare like a starter?
Well, I mean, our team, our second team, third team, or what have you, I mean, when we get in, we have to play like we're a starter because, I mean, we can't have no letdowns. That's just how our team is. So, I mean, whatever string you are, you have to play like you're a starter because at any given time, somebody can go down and you have to come in. So, I mean.
The offense struggled in the first half. You get behind late in the third quarter, 29-28. It's mm-hmm. first and 10 on your own 15, 85 yards of real estate. What's going on in the huddle?
I mean, we knew, I mean, at any given time, the game could shift. I mean, and we just have to stay together as a team. I mean, we've been down before, and we faced adversity like this before. So, I mean, I think everybody was still focused on a goal at hand. That was winning the national championship.
A second-generation Bowden football player here. How does it feel to bow out now down with the national championship?
It's, you know, what a great feeling, you know. One thing I remember is just that, I mean, this team will always be remembered for, you know, going undefeated. No other FSU team did that before. And it's just, you know, I feel I'm kind of limbo right now, you know. I was just in the shower just thinking, like, yeah, we just won the national championship. And it's, I'm so happy for the entire team, you know, the coaches. It's what a great feeling.
A generation ago, your dad played for Coach Bowden at West Virginia. He was here throughout the week. This mm-hmm. had to be a special week. Any story you could tell us about the two of you?
It's great, you know, my family's here, and we had a great time, you know, this throughout the whole week. We went out to eat and stuff, and it's been real positive, you know, and what a great conclusion right now, so I'm happy.
There came a pivotal point in this football game when momentum swung to the other side of the field, that you had to get it done. It came late in the third, early in the fourth quarter. What was going on? What was taking place in that Seminole huddle?
Well, you probably saw on the sidelines, we were probably real quiet, you know, we had that serious look, but one thing we never lost, we never lost confidence. And the entire team, we just kept on pushing and pushing, you know, and things started clicking, and then it went our way, so I'm happy it did.
Jason, you don't want to take the uniform off?
Nah, I know, I don't know if I'll ever put another one on, but it's a great feeling, and I was kind of sad to see my career coming down, but I'm glad it came on a good note.
Wire to wire, undefeated, and now you got a ring on your finger.
Oh, most definitely. And I think that was the toughest thing about going wire to wire. You know, every team, each week we're hunting for us, and it's a tough thing to do, go wire to wire, but we did it. And I just think this is team leadership with Chris and Pete and Corey just helped us out so much this year.
What was the toughest part about this football game in New Orleans against Virginia Tech in the trenches?
I think the toughest part was just waiting for the game to get here. It was awful boring, waiting and waiting and waiting. You know, we've been here enough times. We know what the sites are. The toughest thing was just waiting to get at these guys.
Virginia Tech came in with a big reputation. Did they live up to it, in your estimation?
No, I don't think so. I don't think they were that great of a team.
This is the most popular tandem in the Superdome now, the Thomas twins, right? Yeah, all right. Yeah. Tarlis, you were doing a lot of pointing this evening. Did you find Corey Moore? Did you find those guys?
Yeah, I located that mic, and once I did that, Big Tarlis and the rest of the guys, they knew what to do, and they did a heck of a job.
What made you guys effective with Corey Moore in this game?
The main thing was just getting off the ball. You know, he's great getting off the ball, and we beat him off the ball. And once you put your hands on him, he's so small, he can't do anything, you know. So, I mean, I guess he played his game during the week talking to the media.
Well, that stuck in your craw a little bit, didn't it?
He did a lot of talking about this and that. And, a lot of people do their talking during the week, but we do our talking in the game day.
They had about 20 snaps to your three before you finally got it going. What was taking place in that huddle when you came back out? You converted on third down, then there's a home run to Peter.
Well, I mean, the mood was, okay, here we go again, we down, you know. We've been down all season, you know, and there's nothing new to us, you know, so we just wanted to just drive, you know what I'm saying? If we want the rain, hey, we're going to have to get in the end zone, and hey, number nine. That's, what can you say?
Up top two, and you hit one to Ron Dugans.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, they was talking about making big plays before the game, and they went out there and did it.
Jeff Cheney in the second half.
What can I say? Hey, that's a game-breaker. Like Lee Corso says, boom. You know what I'm saying? He's a slasher.
Do that one more time.
Boom.
Ryan, you talked about running for the 2000 All-American squad. You're going to finish 2000 as the national champs.
That's right. Feels great, doesn't it? Going wire to wire, undefeated. Yep. Only thing, we're going into 2000 number one again, so we can repeat and go 22-0, huh? 24-0.
Offense struggled in the first half. What was it like on the sidelines?
It was very similar to any of our other games on the sidelines, where we knew we were facing a little bit of adversity, might be a little bit confused. We knew going into the game, we'd eventually wear them down and be able to figure out what was going on, and we did. And a lot of that's tribute to Winky and Warwick and Whitaker, a lot of our seniors on the front, is our ability to stay composed. And
you got to fight for your life. It's 30 minutes now. It's down to gut. They're sitting over there determining where they want it worse than us. A defense, you must not get beat at the line of scrimmage. You must defeat the blocker, and then we must tackle. Kickoff, Janikowski, get the ball where don't kick it down the middle. Get it out of there where they can't return. They had great field, great returns. Man, we got to get there and make the tackle. Must contain Vic. They don't score a win. They kick off to us. Contain on the long touchdowns. The replacements on special teams. We got guys hurt. We got Polly hurt. We got Mario out. We got several guys out. You guys are taking their place. You want to win that ring, you've got to do it. You sub tackles that go in there from the starting tackles. You got to play like them. And defensive ends and all of us. Everybody ready to go out and fight for
them. Everything you got for the championship.
Get yourself, fellas. Come on.
Dodge welcomes you back to New Orleans for Sugary Sweet, a Seminole celebration, where Florida State's defense surrendered yards in abundance to Virginia Tech's remarkable freshman Michael Vick. But the Hokie quarterback would pay a punishing price. Linebacker Bobby Rhodes forcing a fumble from behind that the Noles recovered. The All-American Corey Simon collecting one of seven Florida State sacks with an undaunted rush. And even when Vic, with those quick feet, got the pass away, Chris Woods would leave a garnet and gold calling card. A 12th and final foe vanquished.
I'm with Corey Simon here. He finishes out his senior year. You finish out on top.
You couldn't draw it up any better than this. I mean, these guys came out and they fought hard. We've been through so much this season, and guys continue to just stay together and come out here and put together a great performance. We got down and these guys just got stronger.
Have you faced anybody any quicker, any more dangerous than Michael Vick?
He is a phenomenal athlete. I mean, you know, just when you think you have him down, he squirts out of there and runs 15, 20 yards on you. That's your future Heisman Trophy winner.
You scored two defensive touchdowns, a Warwick punt return and a Tommy Polly block. Had you talked about that going into the ball game?
That's been our goal all season long. You know, it's not our offense's job to just put points up. It's ours as well. And, you know, we just wanted to go out in all phases of the game and go out there and play well. And, you know, our special teams play stepped it up tonight. Our defense stepped it up when we had to. Our offense came together when it had to. I mean, everything worked for the good. And that's why we're walking out of here national champs.
Wire to wire, number one, national champs.
Wire to wire.
With Mario Edwards, wire to wire, undefeated, national champs.
Couldn't be any better. You know, our goal from the beginning of the season was to go undefeated and play for the national championship. We did that, you know, and so here we are in New Orleans as national champs.
The tools that Michael Vick brings to the table, he's unlike anybody you faced.
Oh, he brought the wrench, the hammer, the screwdriver. He brought every tool you can think of, you know, but we stuck together out there and did what we had to do to be victorious tonight.
Coach Andrews' second half, what did he talk about at halftime?
Well, he just told us that we had to stay together. You know, guys seemed like they wanted to break up a little bit, you know, but coach got us together and we rallied on the win.
You look back on your career 10 years from now, what's going to be your favorite memory from right now?
12-0, national champs.
What's the feeling in this locker room, a national championship for Florida State?
Well, I feel it right now. It's a great feeling. You know, we've been wanting this all year, and we just came to play tonight.
Shocking development on the first drive. Virginia Tech takes the football and moves it the length of the field. And then what happens?
You know, as they were driving, we just knew we had to come up and make a big play. And I think I hit Vic and made him fumble and got the turnover.
What did you see at the snap of the football? What were you doing?
It was an option all the way here, but he kept the ball and I just held me. He let go ball.
What did that do for the Seminole sideline there?
Oh, it pumped us up. You know, then we stopped the score and we gave offense a chance to move the ball.
Tonight, two touchdowns out of the kicking game for this ball club.
As the kicking game, we knew we had to play big tonight, and we thought their kicking game was going to do it, play big also. We just had to outplay the kicking game, and which we did. So that was the big thing about that.
With Bradley Jennings, you were a popular guy out there. It seemed like every time Michael Vick came up to the line of scrimmage, he was pointing at you.
You know, we came out tonight, and we knew that we had to stem around, you know, the linebacking core, and to kind of confuse him. You know, he's still a young player, but he's a great one too, though.
Struggled a little bit in the first half, shut it down in the second half. What adjustments did you make?
Oh, I think we knew that we had to kind of contain him, you know, and get a lot of more pressure up the middle and get out them more.
Coach Mickey Andrews, tough guy to play for, but a great guy to play for?
Well, is he great? Mickey Andrews, he comes up with all type of ideas and plays, you know, to get out the people, and that's the type of coach I like.
Congratulations.
All right, thank you.
To the roar of the crowd, the champ and the Noles remarkable game breaker. Next.
These days, there are all sorts of cute little compact SUVs running around.
And
lots of monsters lumbering about. But Dodge Durango is different. Roomier than the little ones, more manageable than the huge ones. The just right-sized Durango. Perfectly positioned between the toys and the tanks. Now lease a Dodge Durango for $345 a month.
Excuse me, we need wings, lots of wings.
How many?
Well, it's a Super Bowl party. How many do you think?
A million?
A million.
We do sell 25 million Gold Kiss Farms chicken wings a year.
Well, it is a big party, and we really need, how many?
2 million.
2 million?
You better order them early.
2 million, huh?
Yeah, 2 million.
Better order your wings early, too.
Yeah, I'll be leaving on the 18th, sometime in the morning, back on the 21st. Then what's the last flight out? What's the one before that? Perfect. Yeah, go ahead and book that one.
You know, Dad, this isn't brain surgery.
Now Southwest Airlines gives you the freedom to plan and purchase your flight online. It's so easy, even a grown-up can do it.
Now all you need is the confirmation number. Can I go play now?
You are now free to move about the country.
You've got a key to your house. You've got a key to your car. Well, now you've got a key to the pump. SpeedPass from Mobil. It's your personal key to getting in and out of the station fast. Just wave it at the pump, gas up, and go. To get your free speed pass, call now, toll free. Mobil Speed Pass is linked to a major credit card or check card you already have. Over 3 million people are already getting gas faster with Mobil Speed Pass, the fastest way to get gas.
From New Orleans, Dodge presents Sugary Sweet, a Seminole celebration where the fourth quarter near the French Quarter belonged to Florida State.
High formation, dropping when he goes toward the end zone, caught, touchdown! Rob Dugans, touchdown FSU!
Leadership by example from Chris Wincke, Ron Dugans, and the game's most valuable player in Peter Warwick, sealing a national championship victory in the trio's final game together. In garnet and gold. Well, the Sugar Bowl's never seen an offensive explosion like this. How many touchdowns did you all say you were going to get before this started?
I mean, me and Dude talked about it every day. You know, I said I was going to score three. He said he was going to score two. I mean, we did what we had to do, and we're just happy to be here.
Chris, there was a time here in the first quarter, third down conversion situation here, you were able to hit Ron.
Yeah, that's what it's all about. You know, we had watched enough film. We prepared long enough for this game. We just couldn't wait for it.
I told Ronnie earlier, before the game started, that the biggest thing for us to have success tonight is for him to be able to get off a jam. I said, if you just run a simple slant route and you catch that thing, it's a touchdown. That's exactly what happened.
Yeah, a couple of times. First the third down, and then the home run. DB goes for the pick, tried to knock it down, and you were off and running.
Yes, you know, I told Wink that, you know, the guy couldn't stop me. And, you know, just like he said, he was saying that we got to get off that press, get off the jam, you know, and try to make something happen. I gave him a good stick, you know, Wink put the ball, you know, where it's supposed to be put. And, you know, I made something happen.
Peter, the Virginia Tech had run close to 20 plays, and you guys had run about five before the long pass for the first score of the game. What took place there?
I mean, it was just basically just a slant and go, and, you know, the corner bit on it. And, you know, Wink put the ball where it had to be, and the offensive line stepped it up and made great plays tonight. And, you know, it's just a great honor to have those guys on my team and on my side. And, you know, but everything that I did tonight, I just thank God for it.
The punt return, 59 yards.
Oh, appreciate it.
Off and running. You were sitting, you were waiting on that, weren't you?
Yeah, you know, I was waiting on that, you know. He always, Ron always tell me, Pete, man, get on the punt return. And, you know, I said, man, it's not my turn. You know, coach said, Pete, go out there. So when I went out there, you know, I just thought about the things that, you know, that I needed to do to help this team win in any way possible. And I know if it was the return to punt, you know, that's what I do. And I did it, and, you know, I just thank God for it.
Gut check time of this championship came early in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, no question about it. I think we came out flat in terms of the offensive side of the football in the second half. We had a 14-point lead and maybe got a little complacent. I wasn't firing strikes like I was maybe early on in the game. They did some different things on defense. But, again, we respond to adversity. This football team, there were a lot of question marks surrounding this team. Nobody thought we could go wire to wire. No one thought we could go 12-0. And enough of that garbage. And they talked all week about what they were going to do to us. We get to do all the talking now. We're 12-0. We're the best team in the country, and that was obvious tonight.
It was a wonderful moment there, too. The crowd was going, Peter Warwick, Peter Warwick, the Superdome, the record crowd here in the Superdome, cheering for Peter. What does that make you feel like now, Peter, after all you've been through here?
I mean, that made me feel good, and, you know, the play before that, you know, coach had called a takeoff, and, you know, I went over there when, you know, the crowd was calling my name, and, you know, I asked the offensive line, hey, y'all want me to finish him? And, you know, they looked at me and said, finish him. And, you know, that's what I did. You know, I made a play, and, you know, I finished.
Hey, Dukes, you're surrounded by some great talent here, huh?
Yeah, it feels good, you know, play around a group, this great group of guys, you know, that I'm playing around. You know, I've been playing around these guys, you know, for a while now, and it feels good. So, you know, I just want to thank God for just putting me in the place I'm in right now.
Wire to wire, undefeated, never been done in the history of college football. Congratulations, MVP as well. You get an extra trophy.
Huh? Yeah, you know, it's just great. It's a great honor, you know, playing with Ron Dugans for 5 years. You know, he's a great player, and, you know, a lot of people don't respect him, but, you know, he get the respect that he deserves tonight.
He certainly did. 80 and 16, celebrate this one.
We're going to celebrate this one. I can promise you that.
The man. Hey, congratulations, guys.
Bobby Bowden's crystal ball, a crowning jewel to a perfect season, and a moment with the man in his finest hour.
You see so many Dodge Rams in the New South because they're the longest-lasting line of full-size pickups on the road. But there's a lot more to Ram's popularity than longevity. Take this Ram quad cab. It includes a Magnum V8 engine, a savings of $595, plus air, power windows, power locks, and more. Now it also includes a great low lease, just $289 a month. Either way, you get a great truck, a great price. What more could you ask? Dodge Ram and the New South. Different.
No, watch this. I learned how to do this from my kids.
Great shot! Oh, look out! Who is that? Height? Wow!
Oh. Ow! Jeez. I knew you'd miss it. Hey, what is going on out there? You got weird neighbors.
Don't you just love rookies?
Yeah.
Florida State Seminoles, the undefeated 1999 national champions. Congratulations from Sunshine Network on your perfect season and number one ranking. When the lightning strike, The Islanders are left frozen in their tracks. Lightning. Islanders, tonight at 7 on...
Because trees provide more than just wood for our homes. They improve our lives in unexpected ways. Through the Log a Load for Kids program, professional foresters and loggers are helping sick and injured children. By supporting hospitals around the state, the Log a Load for Kids program helps kids be kids again. Another way that trees make life better. We're the Florida Forestry Association, and we believe in keeping Florida forests forever.
At Superior Bank, we help homeowners. That's what we do. And we've been busy helping homeowners in all kinds of credit and income situations for over 75 years, consolidating your high-interest credit card debt, reducing the number of your monthly payments to just one, and getting you the cash you need when you need it, working with you, simply, easily, and honestly. That's Superior Bank at 1-888-678-7777.
In capitalism.
Sunshine Net, home of Florida State Center.
At the age of 70, Bobby Bowden stands the tallest in college football as Dodge presents Sugary Sweet, a Seminole celebration, and a former Noah Gray with his college coach.
And now we hear from the man himself, Seminole head coach Bobby Bowden. Coach, in 93, you used one word to describe the national championship, relief.
Yeah.
What's your word in 99?
This would be more satisfying to me personally, and I think to the players too. They don't have to go through that relief thing, you know, but I've been in it. I'd been in it so long and never won one that when we finally did in 93, it was like, oh, the load's off your shoulder. You finally won a national championship. Well, this one, you feel like you built on it, you know. This one wasn't any luck.
First half, offensively, two big plays. First 59-yard touchdown reception by Peter Warwick.
Mm-hmm. Well, we are really that kind of a football team. Keith, the old saying they used to have back when you were playing, and especially when I was playing, that you got to run the football to win, that's not true anymore. If you have a great pass game, I don't know if we got 7, 8, 10 yards rushing in that game, but we hit big plays and big plays. They'd keep it 6 minutes, we'd score in 15 seconds, you know, and things like that. And that's the kind of football team we are, and you can win that way.
Second touchdown reception of the first half was Dugan's on a great catch, but maybe a better throw by Winky.
Oh, yeah. Winky did a good job. But Dugan's, see, they were putting a lot of, wherever Pete went, he got a lot of attention. So Dugan's kept them honest on the other side. I'll be honest with you, we had a couple of those that would have had a couple more touchdowns, but we didn't see it.
Now, you said all week when you were looking at the bowl games, you'd never seen so many blocked kicks. You get one of your own.
And that's the truth. As I watched the film last week, watched the games last week, seemed like every team would get an extra point or field goal blocked. And that's the easiest protection there is. So, boy, we harped on it and harped on it and harped on it. Billy Sexton, who coaches our kicking team, did another good job of taking care of that.
You go up 28-7, 22 unanswered points. Michael Vick. Certainly deserving of a number three ranking in the Heisman.
Yeah.
Big things from him in the future, I'm sure.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And the second quarter, we had a chance to turn that game into a rout. We got a 28-7 lead, and we were inside their 30 by mistakes two times and get nothing out of it, you know? And I'm thinking, uh-oh, we might let something slip away. Then they score. Now you got a 28-14 ball game at the half. Then they come out and take over the second half, and we can't answer them, but our kids came back in the fourth quarter and did what they've been doing all year, and that's come from behind and win.
And that fourth quarter comeback started late in the third quarter.
Yeah.
You take the ball on your own 15, 85 yards away,
yeah,
and your offense, particularly that senior-dominated offense, really took over.
Did the same thing against the University of Miami, did the same thing against the University of Virginia, did the same thing against Clemson University. When we were behind, our offense responded, doing whatever they had to do. That was a great drive by Winky.
Now, Coach, when you look at some of the personalities on this team, the first guy, at least I look at, is Peter Warwick, MVP of the game, 20 points, most individual points ever in the Sugar Bowl. Redemption for his year, I know he didn't think about it that way, but he really capped it off in a big way.
And it was redemption that he didn't plan it that way, but it was redemption because he caught so much heck this year because of his actions, which were not very wise, you know. But I think people probably forgave him last night. And I think once they saw him in interviews, they see he's a naive, good young man. that made a very poor decision. But man, the lesson he learned from that, he won't ever do it again.
On the defensive side of the ball, Corey Simon, two-time consensus All-American, but I want your comment. Off the field, he really took charge second half of the season, particularly bowl week.
Oh, Corey Simon is a leader on the field and off the field. Last year, he was a first-team All-American. Now, he was a second-team defensive tackle to start the year. But the other guy gets hurt, he moves in there, and they can't get him out of there. He's an All-American. And so then this year, he's coming back, he's the leader. When our team voted for captains, right before we came down here for permanent captains, he got more votes than anybody. So you can see how the players feel about him.
Now, 1999, in my estimation, has been a year of numbers. Your 70th birthday, your 50th wedding anniversary, and now your second national championship.
Right. It really has. It's been, then of course, playing Tommy for the 300th win and thing. It's been an amazing year, and it's come out on a plus side for us every time. Could have been just messed up. Tommy could have killed a dadgum thing, you know? But it's ended up a great year and a great way to finish this millennium.
Now, you cheated. You cheated. Now, Terry got his 11-0.
Yeah.
Tommy got his 11-0, and in order to get your undefeated, you went 12-0. One more.
Yeah, and I went many, 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 many years past my prime to get it, too.
All right, now I got to ask you this last question. You got to give me the right answer, the correct answer, the honest answer. Mm-hmm. We've talked all week long, in fact, a couple of months, about this picture frame. You've got this picture frame.
It is there.
Now, my question is, did you already have a picture of the 99 Seminole squad stuck in that bottom left-hand drawer, and all you're going to do is put it in that frame, or you got to get somebody to get you a picture?
I absolutely did not have that picture down there in my dad's drawer. Now, that frame's been there since you were there. We had a chance to do it when you were there, but you wouldn't win the bowl game for us.
That wasn't my fault.
No, but I do have that frame, and as soon as the game was over, in our dressing room, I don't know where he got it, Dave Harder, athletic director, came in and gave me an 8x10 photograph of this football team we made last week in the bowl. So that picture will go in the frame the next time you come by my office.
Well, Coach, I got to tell you, I've got three constituencies that I represent: the alumni, letter winners, and Sunshine Network. And on behalf of all of us, we congratulate you on finishing the decade, and our wish is you have another decade better than this one.
Well, I hope so. Florida State deserves it. It's been a great privilege to represent that university, and it is so good that we go into the next millennium as the number one football team in the nation.
How much Bobby, Ann, and the Bowden family have given to the college game?
Dodge Caravan is available with a value package that includes air, 7-passenger seating, and convenient storage areas at a very affordable price. This package has helped sell one Caravan after another, after another. Now Caravan is the world's best-selling minivan. Special value. Best-selling. Get the picture. Get 0.9 financing for 60 months or $1,500 cash allowance on Dodge Caravan.
Year one, the Orlando Predators invade the arena and transform it into the jungle. We invented rock and roll football. In the new millennium, we'll carry on the traditions that made us great with 5 arena bowls and a world championship. Great fans, great football, and great fun. Predators 10th anniversary season tickets start as low as $40. Hey, everybody's got $40 to burn. Call 407-648-4444. Has it really been 10 years? Time flies when you're having fun.
Seminole fans, call now and start receiving the Osceola for the most comprehensive coverage available on Florida State University sports. The Osceola gives you the behind-the-scenes coverage you can't get anywhere else. From practice reports and locker room chatter to in-depth interviews with the coaches and players of your favorite college sports program. With over 42 years of experience covering Florida State, the Osceola staff gives you Seminole sports as no other media source can. You can get your information on the Seminoles a lot of places, but if you want real insight, you need the Osceola. Call now.
Now now free to move about the country.
From New Orleans, Dodge presents Sugary Sweet, a Seminole celebration brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Florida. Who asked, what if you didn't have to worry about health care? By acctoday.com. Follow the Seminoles on the internet at acctoday.com. And by Checkers, fresh because we just made it. Bobby Bowden formally accepted the Sears Trophy, presented by the American Football Coaches Association in recognition of the national title, a championship made even sweeter by coaching great Grant Taft, representing college coaches, with a $20,000 gift to the university. And a consensus number one vote from writers and broadcasters meant the Associated Press Trophy will be showcased in Tallahassee. The Seminoles return to Florida in triumph. And while the cheers of thousands may subside, the memories of this perfect season will last a lifetime.